And Kelly is running for reelection as deputy chair. So Kelly, come on up.
Well, it's great to be in my very own home congressional district, so thank you very much. You know, I gotta say, there were a lot of us that woke up the day that the redistricting numbers came out and realized we went to bed one night being part of CD6 and waking up in CD4. And a lot of us were disappointed about it, but those who'd been in CD4 said, misery loves company, so come on over. But I do want to say, you know, it is tough if you're in St. Paul, because I lived there once, it's tough being a Republican in St. Paul. And when I look at our projections from 2008 and realize that we had a U.S. Senate Republican candidate that lost by 312 votes, it's crucial that our candidates spend more time in the areas where they're not comfortable being the city. But for those of you, I want to recognize, you know, there was some success, though, in this election cycle. Matt Dean, Bob Detmer, Kathy Lohmer, Andrew Kiefer, Senator Chamberlain, Senator Housley. And I want to point out, I need to give a special plug to Representative Kathy Lohmer. The Democrats spent more money on her House race than any other House race out there, and she won by more than 5 percentage points. So that is huge. Thank you so much. So as your deputy chair, I bring great experience to the job. I have successful and proven fundraising experience, extensive training background, and most importantly, I have winning campaign experience as the campaign manager for Senator Ted Lilly in 2010, as well as coordinating through that campaign with Kathy Lohmer and Andrea Kiefer. And it is no secret that I was elected to serve our party at one of the most tumultuous times that we've ever faced. When I was elected on Saturday, December 3rd, I went into the office on Monday. And this, I can say this because I'm Irish, this is the typical luck of the Irish. There was not a penny in the bank, and it was not a 2 payroll month, but it was a 3 payroll month. So immediately I pulled people together and executed a plan and sent them out and said, our number one job right now is to raise money. So together, we raised $167,000 in that 1 month of December to keep our doors open, our lights on, and make sure the few employees that we did have left working hard got a paycheck and had a good Christmas. I've also been on the ground training BPOU leaders and working side by side with our grassroots volunteers, our candidates, and our campaigns. You know, being on the ground and being out there across the state, I do know we are only 7 seats away from taking back the majority in the House of Representatives. The reality, though, is that we were only 2,899 votes away from actually keeping the majority in the House of Representatives in 2012. So when I look forward to 2014, there are 3 crucial goals that I see. Number one, we all need to come together. We need to work to take back our majority in the House. And I'm going to tell you, there are 2 seats right here in this district that I know that we can work to get back. One is we're going to unseat Barbara Russo and Peter Fisher. We also need to work to unseat Mark Dayton and say goodbye to Al Franken.
Yeah.
And I'm going to remind you that Al Franken was the 60th vote for Obamacare, making it a filibuster. So there are 3 things I came up with: dollars, data, and delivery. Like it or not, we got to continue raising money. Money is the crucial component of any campaign and party operation. Data. We need to immerse ourselves in every community and understand not only who the voters are, but we also need to understand what matters to our voters. And delivery of a clear and unified message. We need to be at the ground level. We need to be on the same talking points, filter it to the ground, and let everybody reframe that in 10 different ways so that it does resonate with all voters. We need to treat every single voter in this state as a likely Republican voter. and I will continue the training with the election of new BPOU officers. I want to thank you. Time is running out. Thank you to our grassroots volunteers for operating more phone banks across the state, making a record 2.1 million voter contact calls. You made a difference. You set a strong foundation for winning in the future. Let's make Minnesota the state that says, come to Minnesota for freedom, stay for jobs.
Thank you.